bought 40 acres in 1993 and decided it would be a great place to finally build a home and retire.
I am fifth generation. My great-great-grandfather homesteaded here.
Yep, let's go. Let's go. The gate's that way. Let's go. What are you waiting on, Maya? Yep. Sarah, go on. Go on.
We have 300 head of elk that come down out of the high country. They're incredibly beautiful.
I'm a fourth generation rancher. When I was little, Dad would let me have two cows out of the herd so I could have my own herd.
One of my favorite things is the red-winged blackbirds. And it's usually, honey, honey, the red-winged blackbirds are back, you know. This has been my favorite place I've ever lived in my life,
this,
I must say.
Representatives, is on your watch.
People
it's
have called and complained to every regulatory
entity. House and Senate consider legislation today directing President Biden.
Today's witnesses represent oil companies that made more than $36 billion in profits.
$120 a barrel. Now is not the time for topping off.
There she is. We call it our new neighbor, Neighbor 907.
We are in a split estate situation where we own the surface and someone else owns the mineral rights. And what happens in Colorado, and I think in most Western states, is the mineral rights are dominant.
The law on mineral extraction goes back hundreds of years that says the mineral owner has a right to extract that mineral. And to a certain extent can extract it and impact the surface without compensation.
We have 70 acres here, and I can't convince them that they need to drill somewhere besides 200 feet from our house.
The energy policy has been to drill, 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 and drill some more.
They're a very strong industry. They've got a tremendous amount of political influence and an awful lot of money.
As a civil servant, I spoke out. But it's difficult to do so because you feel constantly that you're risking your job and your family's future.
Oh yeah, it burns.
Yeah, I'd say.
As I sat there and looked out my window into my backyard, all I could think was, there's no way I can stay out of this. I'm sitting here with all of the right resources. These people need help.
This is before any problems, before we lived in Rifle. And then everything changed.
They're motivated by profits, and unfortunately, they're motivated by short-term profits. They don't take the long view.
Times I said, you come out here and live. You come out here and live in my house for a week. I have no rights.
The Rocky Mountains are seeing an unprecedented boom in oil and gas drilling. Montana, Wyoming, Colorado, New Mexico, Utah. The boom is happening all over the country. There's oil and gas operations in 32 states right now, but the Rocky Mountain states are really seeing the vast majority of the expansion.
Don't believe for 1 minute that anything is off limits. 150 feet away from your house, 1.5 times the length of the derrick. So if it falls over, it won't hit your house. We see this look on people's faces. And they get that look and they say, well, wait a minute, that can't be right. That's not fair, that can't be. But it is. That's the way it is.
This is an active drilling rig near a small house showing just how close the two can be and how large the pad is. During drilling, a site can cover several acres before it is reduced to a smaller pad for the producing well. Oil and gas deposits below ground contain toxic compounds that are brought to the surface during drilling. These compounds pollute the environment and can cause health problems. But the impacts of drilling are made even worse by the chemical products that are injected during the process. Dr. Colborne has documented over 200 products used in Colorado drilling. Over 90% contain chemicals with adverse health effects.
When we purchased, I asked the seller about the mineral rights, and he said he didn't have them to sell.
85% of landowners in Colorado do not own the rights to the minerals under their land.
Until you get on the federal property, I think it is private interests that own the mineral rights all through here. Once you get on the forest or BLM, then of course it's the government.
Up here with my dad in the late 40s, early 50s, there wasn't a single, not even one oil and gas well. Now there's, I mean, you can't even count them, there's so many.
ConocoPhillips operates about 10,000 wells here in the basin, which is an incredible number of wells to try and manage on a daily basis. And so as a simple example, we do well reviews and look at what our wells should be delivering. If we spend 5 minutes per well, it takes about 9 months to go through that process.
Everything below us down here is our Armenta Canyon. If you get up on the big Harris Mesa benches, those benches are just littered with wells, approximately 500 all total. And now with the new well spacings that they approved, we'll go from about 500 to about 1,500 within the next 20 years.
We drill, it averages about 350 new wells per year. When you take the Colorado side and include that, we think that ConocoPhillips has probably another 10,000 wells that we will drill in the basin over the next 40 years, say.
See all them bubbles in that water up there, Bob?
Yeah.
Looks like little fish jumping.
Jesus, yeah.
That's all gas coming up there.
On both his and our properties, there was the evidence of bubbling in the creek. We didn't know what it was. It looked like a Pepsi can. There was just an eruption of bubbles fizzing all over the place, in the reeds and in the water.
It's percolating all over this field.
There's just thousands. This field is just covered with them.
We've been here 18 years, and this is the first time I've seen anything like this.
And now, it's funny, it just started happening the day they started fracking.
We notified the EPA, DOW, the health department, and then we called and notified the state. And so my dad went down in Black Cloud. He's of Native American heritage and decided, okay, they're not listening to us. He waded into the water, and when he did, a cauldron of bubbles just erupted all around him.
In an effort to convince authorities that the bubbling was not occurring naturally, Lisa and her family demonstrated that the gas would ignite.
Yeah, let's go ahead and light it.
Oh yeah, it burns.
Yeah, I'd say.
Keep your face out.
Yeah, yeah.
2001, gas wells were drilled using the fracking technique a mere 500 feet from the Amos home. Underground, the drilling breached their water well, causing their drinking water to fill with gray sediment and fizz like soda pop. The Colorado Oil and Gas Conservation Commission tested the water well and found methane, but said it was safe. But they warned the Amoses to keep a window open so the methane gas wouldn't build up and cause an explosion in their home. The Amoses stopped drinking the water, but continued to bathe in it.
A young woman called me from Garfield County and said that she had developed a rare adrenal tumor, that she had had this incident with her well. That was the beginning. I mean, when she called, it just sent chills up and down my spine. She had been breastfeeding her daughter through the period when they were using the water that they were told was safe. She was bathing her baby in the water in their home. They were breathing this stuff that was coming into their house.
She later found out that a chemical that had been used in the 2001 fracking has been linked to adrenal gland tumors. When she went to Encana, they denied using it on that well or any other. Months later, the Oil and Gas Commission admitted that it had been used after all.
Laura was told her water was safe, but we found out later they never tested it for 2BE. They waited till 4 years after the incident to go back to see if possibly they could find some. That was long gone.
In 1995, they bought their dream house, a fixer-upper in a rural neighborhood outside Rifle.
We fell in love with the place and we plan to just stay there forever.
It was shortly after Chris and Steve moved in that drilling rigs began to appear on some of their neighbors' land and in the surrounding hills.
And then everything changed.
Chris would get in the shower and her skin turned bright red. I think it was 96.
Her skin was
burning on fire. She would swell.
Steve began to develop symptoms as well.
I'd feel dizzy. I'd get bloody noses, bleed to death. She'd wake up in the morning and she would be covered in blood. And her nose would be bleeding just like crazy. And the pillow was covered with blood. The sheets were covered with blood.
Well, around 50% of the chemicals cause such things as kidney damage, cardiovascular problems. And then the next, and very troublesome, are the neurological effects.
I started showing up and just wanting to just hold my body because I feel like something's happening inside of me, you know, it is not normal.
Chris's health began to deteriorate rapidly. She began losing her sight, had severe headaches, and had pain in her hands and feet. There were two surgeries to remove a pituitary tumor, and she developed a rare neurological speech impairment. It became increasingly difficult for her to speak clearly.
I've had several patients who have been having symptoms since the time that they were exposed to oil and gas exploration near their homes.
After we started thinking, something's not right, put a glass of water out and left it sit overnight, and there was like a little oil slick on top. And then...
he lit a match to it.
It burned.
And I think, oh my God, I've been drinking that.
And this is the water that they said was safe to drink.
In desperation, Chris and Steve moved to Grand Junction, Colorado, abandoning their home and a place that had been their dream.
We just up and left, you know, the place. And it was valued at $440,000, and we just walked away from it.
No gas, no oil!
We're not about to compensate people for full value loss of their property.
And anybody in this room...
There's a growing resistance on the part of people who live in the path of drilling.
They're lying to us!
I object to any company that will come in, drive people out of the homes that we built with our own hands, and homes that we have every right to expect to live out of our homes.
I have to say that living with this development has affected our lives in nearly every way imaginable.
With no other recourse, some landowners have become activists.
My well was blown out in July 18th of 2006.
Last summer, while you folks probably had air conditioners going on, I had to stay in my house with the respirator on.
Well, I was offered a motel for myself, you know, and some food. That doesn't help the situation. We all can't just move into a motel. There's a lot of us.
Suddenly, a crushing headache overcame me, and I began to collapse. As I was falling, I grabbed the top of my truck door and clung there as my consciousness faded.
I think there's no question that people are getting sick from the environmental effects of oil and gas exploration production throughout the United States.
In the spring of 2007, Governor Bill Ritter signed one of the new Colorado bills. It changed the makeup of the state commission that regulates the industry. The ceremony was attended by some of the residents of Garfield County.
All the poison is in your hands.
Uh-huh. Are these my hands
and in your feet too? Your feet have a lot of pain and itching. Mine are awful.
House Bill 1341 may be one of the most significant things that we accomplished in this legislative session. It reorganized the Colorado Oil and Gas Conservation Commission. And we believe it brings a better balance to the commission so that it's not dominated by any one interest group. But we're going to be responsible as we move forward. We're going to be mindful of the impact as the number of drilling applications climb and as the number of impact complaints climb as well.
Williams is going to have to respectfully decline to participate in your project. We struggled with this decision, but we feel like
I need to let you know that we transfer all video and radio media contacts over to the.
Well, I think at this point, no, I'm not interested in. At this particular point, I don't think there is a story.
We do wish you the best in your endeavors, and thank you for your consideration.
As in the Rocky Mountains, the growth of domestic drilling is beginning to impact people and places across America in ways never imagined. Oil companies are seeking new leases in 32 states. Since 1990, hundreds of thousands of new wells have been drilled, and the pace of development is accelerating. Incredibly, drilling is now planned in the New York City watershed, which provides drinking water to millions. But some feel it doesn't have to be this way.
We can make them do it better. The profits now in the industry are so high that there's no reason why they can't start using some new technology, develop the new technology to capture the escaping gases, the VOCs, but also to do something with that water.